A double shot of energy in the AM. Rob Thompson, Rudy J. R&R in the morning on San Antonio Sports Star. ESPN 1250 and 103.3 FM.
It's R&R in the morning. Leon Valley is the corrupt government capital of Texas, allegedly.
I don't know anything about that.
Where are you from is my question, and how do you answer that? If you grew up in Castle Hills and you're strolling the streets of New York, you walk up to an old friend, they go, where are you living now? Do you say Castle Hills?
Hell no.
Or you say San Antonio? Where is the separator, and what do you want to be, I guess is the question. And then we got to decide who should never be separated. Like, you're never allowed to say you're from Kirby, Texas. Are you?
No.
No.
Can you say you're from Alamo Heights?
Yes. I don't agree with it.
Wait, so time out. So you mean to tell me that Alamo Heights is draft eligible?
I think that they are.
Wow. I might have to go back into my war room.
Well, the reason I think they're grandfathered in.
But
I don't like it. I don't appreciate it. I don't think it should be that case. But I think they're kind of grandfathered in because I know people, that's what they say. They're from Alamo Heights. Like, Alamo Heights.
Dude, it's dead center. So you know people that say, I'm from Alamo Heights.
Just like there are people that say they're from Katy, and you go, and you're Houston.
Don't get me started on
that. I'm just saying, and people say they're from Heights or Terrell Hill. You're San Antonio.
Yep.
But we left out.
Violence.
So after the show yesterday, a good friend of mine lives in Castle Hills. Reached out and said, I don't know what you're talking about. We are our own town. We got mayor, and we got a police force, and we have a taxing, and we do stuff. We're a town. I don't know why we would be considered anything other than being Castle Hills. I'm like, yeah, shut up. You're from San Antonio.
Now, go back to Pledge. We got the early bird. Go another one back. One more back. Okay. One of the early birds chimed in on Facebook, Rob, since we're doing this whole city draft. Jason Delgado.
I agree with this.
San Antonio expanding around Leon Valley. If we're going to claim balconies and Leon is allowed, side note, if they have a police department, they should be draft eligible. I don't know about that, man.
Just because you got a Barney Fife.
Yeah, that is. I feel you, Jason. What you're saying makes sense. But again, the rule is, if you don't say it when you're out of town, if you don't tell a stranger when you're from out of town that I live in Balcony Heights, if you say you're from San Antonio, your city can't be eligible.
Right.
Right?
So I think Barney is on the edge. I do believe people say they're from Barney, but they have to qualify it. I'm from Barney. It's by San Antonio.
Mm-hmm. But I do think that they say, like,
they right. Have, but if you have to qualify it, then you probably shouldn't count. If you have to say, I'm from Leon Springs, and that doesn't even count. Leon Valley, which is a
municipality. For sure.
It's in San Antonio. No, you're San Antonio.
Okay, so a recap. You took Fredericksburg yesterday?
I took Balcony's Heights.
Yeah.
I took Balcony's because I was in the market for a traffic light. I wanted to make some passive mailbox money.
So you didn't take Fredericksburg?
I did not draft. I only drafted one, and it was Balcony's Heights.
That was it.
But Fredericksburg, we can't draft Fredericksburg. They're on their own. They're Fredericksburg.
That's what we could. I thought that's what we could do. We drafted cities around it. Cities around San Antonio that are their own cities. I thought that's who was eligible.
Yeah, but they have to be quantified as...
They're not in our city limits. They're not even in our county, okay. Fredericksburg.
True.
And I believe that Balcony Heights could stand on its own.
I had to trade. I did a trade.
You did a late draft trade.
I traded Luka Doncic for Trae Young. I took Spring Branch. And then Pledge talked me out of it. So I went into my... I started working the phones. And I traded Spring Branch, and I picked up Castroville. I took Castroville, and Pledge, you took Canyon Springs.
Lake.
Which I didn't know was actually a town, but evidently it is.
They're their town. So, as we start the second round, we're back at the top of the draft, because this is not a snake.
Well, this is not a snake.
This is not a snake.
We're not doing fantasy football.
Which, if I'm Pledge, I would feel a little slighted. We're at the second round, and the Thompsons are on the clock.
Just wondering how this draft order came about.
Well, there's a lot
order.
Of
pecking order, dude.
There was a lot
host,
of thought.
Co-host, producer. That's how. That's kind of how things work.
So yesterday, I kind of thought that Lavernia is Lavernia.
Mm-hmm.
They're not San Antonio.
That's fair.
Now he wants it.
Well, and I thought, well, I might lean into Lavernia. And then I thought, no, I've got it. I'm drafting China Grove.
You're going to take China Grove?
They have their own song. They have a song that tells me they're on their own. They're not San Antonio. The Doobie Brothers told me 50 years ago that China Grove, we can never draft them. We could build around them, but it's always
now. Where's China
be,
Grove, Rob? Help me out.
Southeast side, it's headed east.
Okay. Now what made you take China Grove? What is it about?
They have their own song.
What song?
The Doobie Brothers. When the sun goes down on that sleepy little town.
Oh.
Down around San Antonio.
Wow. But what is going to add to your town? What do they add to your town besides the song?
Good people.
Good people?
I think I've been to China Grove.
You probably.
I'm sure I have.
Rob, you've been here forever. You've been to China Grove.
Really, I mean, but you have to be really awake when you go to China Grove because it ain't much to it.
Okay. Well, good pick.
I'm drafting China Grove for the sole reason they have their own song.
I can dig it.
See, down on Rigsby 410.
I can dig it. I like Rigsby. All right. Well, I got some outside help from Jerry West. You know, Jerry West has always never really worked for anybody. He just helps out in drafts.
He's a consultant.
I have a Jerry West working for me. And because of this town, you know, I thought about it all last night, and then we got confirmation today. We got league approval.
Uh-oh.
My Jerry West told me that this is who I should roll with. And I'm going to go with Alamo Heights. I
understand.
If the houses are 100 years old and still worth $400,000, and you have a high school, and the basketball team's going to state, the soccer team's good, volleyball team's good, you got to go 30 through my town so you can see everything. You got to stop at the boutiques. You got to stop and get some cookies, some candy. That you got. It's Alamo Heights is a one-stop shop, baby.
It is.
Stop helping him.
It's a one-stop shop. I'm going to draft Alamo Heights.
I don't like your insider.
Now there is a certain
what?
I mean,
you lived in Heights for a while.
I lived in the ghettos of Heights. I lived in 09. I did not live in Heights. I lived in 78209, but I lived in the servants' quarters of Alamo.
Oh, so there was like a.
I lived in the 78209 zip code, but I lived on Mankey Park, right there on Broadway. So not Alamo Heights per se, but people would say, "Oh, 09." No, I was San Antonio. But I was in that zip there for a
while. So how you feel about my pick?
I think it's a great pick. But you're bringing in – see, what when you draft Alamo Heights, you just drafted Aaron Rodgers. You get the good and the bad. Now, you get MVP caliber performance.
You're not going to talk about my city
but
like
it's
that.
All that other stuff. Alamo Heights is Aaron Rodgers in the sports world. Yeah, there's some quality there. I'm not going to argue with it. But you get all that other stuff. You got to keep telling him he's handsome and he's pretty and you're not going to have to drive too fast and very much. They might come after you and give you a ticket. So you get the good and the bad when you draft Heights. You just got to accept that. You got a diva.
You know what,
you drafted a diva.
While that stung, it's so true.
It's stung,
but the town is so talented. I'm willing to put up with those flaws.
See, China Grove's just happy to have a jersey.
You picked a Spurs player.
Yeah, China Grove is a Spur.
China Grove is a
they
Spur.
They are a glue guy. They're just happy to be here. They're not going to put any weird taxes out there. They're not going to ask for much more. They just want to be successful and left alone. That's you, on the other hand.
I might have to put up with some divas.
There's some stuff you're going to have
divinous.
To put up with.
It's okay.
But the tax return is going to be good.
Absolutely.
I mean, there is some return on your investment. James?
You're on the clock.
I'm on the clock. Well, since you took Alamo Heights off the board for me, I'm going to go with a nightlife kind of place. Places I like to venture out to. There's Stout House. There's the Green Lantern. There's a mega church there. I get the Rue Pub.
You can't.
I'm taking Stone Oak.
But Stone Oak is not a city, are they?
No.
Are they a municipality? Is there a Stone Oak city?
There's not a Stone Oak PD.
We
got to get confirmation.
No, we have to. You have to have
a
defined city. There has to be some entity that
offers don't even try
election. There has to be a mayor or a city council or a city manager or something.
There's no Stone Oak High.
I'm just sorry. Stone Oak doesn't count because it's also Stone Oak. No,
you can't.
No,
who's your backup?
Because they're not.
It's a good one, though. No, it's
worthy, but I see you're chasing property values and location, and you want to have the nice golf course out there. But
yeah,
I'm sorry. They're not
who's your backup?
Municipality, as it were.
I think it might be.
You had to. Who's your backup? You're on the clock, Minnesota Vikings. Don't miss your pick and not trade out.
Because the clock
is ticking.
He's thinking, does
look, he shook. He shook like, no, you can't take
DeHaanis. Does Lacoste count?
No, I've got a couple others I'm really considering.
Medina?
Castle Hill's nice property value, stuff like that. It's a good part of town.
Hollywood
Park
light.
Has, you know, cops that'll get me money. Mm-hmm. For pulling you over for no reason. Live Oak has an IKEA and a movie theater.
Live Oak is a worthy. We haven't talked Live Oak, and I think that Live Oak might have separated themselves from that Kirby
Live Oak
Universal
legit.
City.
Live Oak is legit.
Mm-hmm. There's a lot in Live Oak. Also, Timberwood Park, very, very underrated.
Timberwood Park is Katy. Same idea.
Well,
San
exactly.
Antonio.
Yeah, who you got?
I'm going to take Live Oak. I like all the things I can do there. I like the food that's around there. I got the mall right there. Or
what
the
mall?
That one at 1604 and 410. Or
Rolling Oaks.
Yeah. Oh, Rolling Oaks, that's right.
Well, I got Rolling Oaks and then the
IKEA.
There's the shopping center right there, that big. Plus, there's a Pluckers.
You got the Forum.
Yeah, the Forum. That's the one I'm thinking of.
Great pick, Pledge.
Where does Live Oak and Garden Ridge, where do they butt up against each other?
You got to get up to 35 a little bit more.
You got to go way up 35.
Good. Hey, Pledge, that's a solid pick. So you have Canyon Lake and Live Oak. I have Castroville and Alamo Heights. Rob has Balcony Heights and China Grove. So round three, Friday. We're only giving y'all one round at a time.
Do former or current military bases count? No? I'm running out of draft options.
If I can't take Stone Oak, you can't take a military base.
Because I was driving around... the tech port.
No,
pretty nice
you,
down there.
No, you can't. No, Rob. Stop.
Joint base. That's pretty nice down there.
Stop.
But I guess they're there.
Round three tomorrow. How many rounds are we going to do before we cut this off?
I think we've already done two too many. But,
yeah, me too. No, actually, I think this is the best.
Live
Oak segment.
Is my set, says Lenora. All right. Oh. Live Oak, respect. No, you know what? When you say
people
Live Oak,
collusion
I,
on you.
I literally do think of them as separate and apart. I do, but when I think of Kirby and Universal City, I think, what are you guys talking about? So I think Live Oak is a worthy grip. The thing we got to watch out of San Antonians is that whole Northeast corridor, the shirts and the Universals and the Cibolos and the Kirbys and the Live Oaks.
Yeah,
they're all kind of forming their own little gang. They're all trying to gang up against us. You got to watch those guys. And they got us all up on the
you
Northeast
side. Putting Live Oak
side.
In there?
Live Oak, well, you know, they might be the leader of the pack.
Yeah.
They went and gotten themselves an IKEA.
No, yeah, what happened? They went out there and they got themselves an IKEA and got all uppity.
Yeah.
Now they got an Evo out there. Now they think they're really something.
Ooh, speaking of which, I get Olympia Hills having Live Oak.
Yeah, nice.
I don't
course.
Know about that.
Yeah, that's Live Oak.
Oh.
Yeah, nice.
That's a good
course.
Pick.
It's right there behind the Forum.
It's a great pick.
And Forum.
I like China reference. Grove too. But I think I won this round.
You might have, as far as all of that. But I have a song.
Round three, Friday. Tomorrow's Friday. We're definitely doing round three. So y'all got to come back for round three. It's Friday. Rob and I are tired as hell. We might do two rounds tomorrow.
You guys have to go consult your local maps.
I got to get back with my. I got to get back with my Jerry West.
We got to
see
figure
who
out
I'm going with round three.
If Flatonia matters.
Pledge.
Oh, Flatonia is worthy, man. Joel's Barbecue
might be enough.